Hey you and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry. In this whole video, I'm going to show you how to install Microsoft Office that will include Microsoft Word, Excel, and even PowerPoint right into your Google account so that you can use it right on your Chromebook. And I'm going to be showing you two different methods right on my Chromebook. There are some things that you do need though. One of them is you have to have your Google account, be able to log into that on your Chromebook. And you also need a free Microsoft account. Now, if you don't have that, all you gotta do is go to Microsoft.com and actually go ahead and click on login and then create a free account there. Like I said, it's absolutely free. And once you have that, you'll be able to actually log into the Microsoft Office apps and use those right on your Chromebook. So let's get started with the lesson. Now for this lesson, I'm going to be using my Acer Chromebook. Any newer Chromebook will do, as long as you have access to the Chrome Web Store or to the Play Store. So go ahead and open up your Chromebook and then log into your Google account. Hey, here I am in the Chromebook. Now the very first thing that you want to do once you get the desktop, as you see here, is go ahead and click on the App Launcher, which is the round icon found in the lower left-hand corner of your screen. Once you do that, it reveals some apps there. If you click on the little carrot, it reveals even more apps, or you can do a search. And we're looking for the Web Store. So go ahead and click on the Web Store, as I have done already. And it opens up into the Web Store there. In the corner there, you notice it has a search box, key in the word Office. And once you hit the Enter key, it'll show the results. Now the very first one that you see there is Office, and it says Office by Microsoft. Go ahead and click it. And right above me, there's a blue button that says Add to Chrome. Go ahead and click that, and then they'll ask you, do you want to add this extension or not? Go ahead, yes, you need to add the extension, and they'll be downloading, installing it there. Boom, now you have Microsoft Office. And this will open up here to this screen. What we're going to need to do is we're going to need to go back to the Chrome Web Store. And so if you look at the very top of my screen, you notice I have tabs. Second to the last tab there is actually the Chrome Web Store. So go ahead and get back into the Chrome Web Store. And we're going to actually install now icons and apps that we need to actually really use this to the full benefit on a Chromebook. So go ahead and click on that. And once you're back into the Web Store, you notice as you'll say something like Office, go back there to the results, and then we're going to scroll down the list. And once you scroll down the list, you notice that you have apps. Now the one of the apps that we need is Microsoft Word. So there's Word Online, and on my button there it says, you know, I already have it because I tested this a little bit earlier just to make sure everything worked very well. It did, but you click on that gray button, Add to Chrome. Next we're going to add Excel and click on Add to Chrome. Once you clicked on Add to Chrome, click on Add App, and then it'll be installing that on your Chromebook there, so you'll be able to use it. And now you'll be able to find these icons down in your App Launcher. So let's test this out, make sure everything works here. What we're going to do is we're going to click on that App Launcher again, and notice recently installed apps will be on the top there, but if not, you can always click on that carrot to reveal more. Let's go ahead and click on Microsoft Word there. And it opens up into this. Now earlier in the video, remember I had you log into your Microsoft account. Well, if you had, you'll actually see all of your documents that you've created inside of your Microsoft account in the past, whether it be on a Windows machine, a Mac, or a different Chromebook. Let's go ahead and let's click on one of those and make sure everything loads properly here. So here we actually see my document, and there's my tools at the top. People have asked me, hey, do you have all the tools? And as you can see there, I actually do have my tools, the most commonly used tools. So that works. Next, we're going to try Excel. So I'm clicking on the Excel icon there, and it opens up. Very first thing that you see within Excel is all of your past worksheets, and there's mine. I've worked on in the past. And if you notice, there's these icons in the corner. If I click on those icons that look like a little box of apps, you notice, hey, there's others such as PowerPoint, Word, Excel. All those are actually there. So here's PowerPoint. And you can see all the PowerPoint presentations that I've created in the past. And what's really nice about this is that everything is saved online within your Microsoft account for you. And as you can see there, it's easy to get to other apps by using that little app launcher there that they have inside of their web-based program. So in this first method I've showed you, basically involves getting into the Chrome Web Store, downloading the apps there. It is totally free. You do not need a subscription to 365 to use it, to edit documents or to save documents or to open up old documents that you've created in the past. And what's really nice about this is, let's say something happens to your Chromebook, you can actually log in with another Chromebook, log back into your Microsoft account, and there's all your work. And before I get into the second method, I would like to remind everyone to please click on the thumbs up icon, as that really helps the channel. Subscribe to my channel, Selma Teacher 7, if you haven't done so already. And if you have a question or a comment, please leave it down in the comments there, and I'll try to get to it as soon as I can. Now, this second method that I'm going to be going over involves getting into the Play Store and doing a search for Microsoft Office there. We're going to be finding Excel and Word and installing those. Those will be the Android versions of those Microsoft apps. And as such, the Android versions do require you to have a Microsoft Office 365 subscription. So if you're a student or if you're at a business which they already give you a Microsoft 365 subscription, hey, guess what? You just log into your 365 and everything's great. If you do not have a 365 subscription, then stick with the first method because everything there is free. Alright, so let's get into the second method. So in this next method here, what we're going to do is click on the Play Store at the bottom here. Click it, and it will open up to the Play Store. Now, we see Microsoft Excel already there, but we're going to find other Microsoft apps by clicking up into the search box and then typing in Microsoft Office. And then hit enter. And there it is. So we have Word, Excel, and we have other Microsoft Office apps all there. Let's go ahead and click on one. So there's Microsoft Word. And click on Install. And then it will be installing right onto your Chromebook. Remember, this is the Android version, so it does have the editing tools there. However, it does require you to have the subscription to 365 in order to actually use all of its features. Now, once it's installed, you can go ahead and click on Open. You will be able to find it in the App Launcher as well. So if I click on the App Launcher, it comes up and it reveals more apps. Click on the carrot. And I'm going to do a search for a word, so I'm going to click in the search box and key in Word. You notice right away I have two versions. I have the Android as well as the Chrome version on my Chromebook. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the Android version here. I'm going to click on Go to Office and let it set up. Again, you need to log into your Microsoft account, and it's going to configure it. You notice that you do have a choice there to go onto the 365 to have all of the features, all of the editing features, I should say, for the Android version. And I'm going to click on one of my documents, one of my old lessons there from 2013. And here it is. Right away, you'll notice that my editing tools are not available because I don't have 365. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the Chrome version and open up a document, and it opens up right away. And you notice right away I have my editing tools at the top. So I'm going to highlight some text here and just see, make sure I am able to edit my document. I'm going to increase the font size. And hey, I'm able to increase the font size to edit or create my document there, so that's great. Again, this is the Chrome version from the first method mentioned here in the video. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to check and make sure I do have the ability to save my document, make sure it's not read only. So I'm going to click on File, And once I click on Save As, I do notice I have the choice to save it within my Microsoft account, to rename it, to download a copy, download PDF, or even as an ODT type of file. So I do have the ability to save it and edit it and all that. So that's great to know that I can edit my documents there. Let's try Excel now and make sure everything works in there. I'm gonna open up one of my spreadsheets. And what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna click in within a random cell and just see if I can add information into the cell here. I do notice that my tools are not grayed out, so I do have my tools available to me. So I'm going to key in some random numbers in here, and it does allow me to do that. Next, I'm going to look at my tools at the very top there, my banners, and you notice I do have all of my banners and all my tools. So that's a good thing there. And again, this is the Chrome version from the first method. If I click on Insert, you notice I have Pivot Table as well as Function and Table and all the others there. So I do have that. I have my Draw Tools, Layout, and all my others. So they are all here. And that is very good news. So there you go. You know that you can edit and save your documents there using the Chrome version. So there you have it. Now you know two different methods for getting Microsoft Office onto your Chromebook or to your Google account. Now, the very first method that I showed you is 100% free and everything works great in that. The second method, using the Android apps, remember, that does require you to have a subscription to 365. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below because I do love to read your comments, and if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel, SelmaTeacher7. Alrighty. Thank you very much for watching the video to the end, and I really do appreciate everyone out there. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.